Hi, in this video we will continue with the series of closest points and the attractor thing. I recommend you watch the first two videos so you can have an idea about the logic of the attractors. I will include this file related to the second video in the description so you can follow along. So what we did in the first two videos is that we created a line. We subdivided this line into points. I added a few points in Rhino using the points tool. I imported these points here. Then I used this closest point component. These points here goes in the cloud input. And these points goes into the point input. So what Grasshopper did here is that for each point, we'll measure the distance between each point and all the points here in the cloud. And when Grasshopper finds the closest point to each point here, a Grasshopper was creating a point, a corresponding point on in the same place of the closest point in the cloud. You can see the created points here, and then for each closest point, Grasshopper was giving us also the distance between the point and its corresponding point somewhere here. And then we were using the distances to move these points and then we created a spline between these points here and then a loft between this spline and the original line, as you can see here. Loft, and then we extruded this loft in the X direction. And here we used a custom preview to give it a color shading. What we will do in this video, instead of using the closest point, we will use the curve closest point. Curve closest point. Now, the reason is that in addition to learning something new, adding points manually like this, it's time consuming. Also, for example, if I take this point here and I drag it very far, you can see that it will stop doing anything. Why? Because now, for Grasshopper, when Grasshopper is measuring the distance between each point here and the cloud, this point will never be closest to any of these points. So multiple points will have their closest point somewhere here. For example, maybe these points here will have their closest point over this point here or this point here. So if I want to be sure that every point in the cloud will have an effect, it's better if I use the curve closest point. Also, manipulating the shape of the curve is easier than just keep clicking on the points and move them around to influence the shape. So let's start first by hiding everything. I will draw a line here to separate the two definitions. I I will bring first those components here. Control C, Control V. I will hide those points for now. This is the line. I can control its length. And the curve subdivision, I will plug the points here. Now for the curve attractor, I can create a line, a curve inside Grasshopper, but I will do this in Rhino. I will click and hold and choose a vertical line. You can choose any type of line, curves. Doesn't have to be vertical, but for this exercise, I will reference this curve here and I will plug it in the curve. Immediately, as you can see, points were created here. You can see the number of points, 24 points here, and the original also 24 points. So here we have 24 and here we have 24. So now I'm sure that for each point there is a point. And here we have the distance between each point and its corresponding point. And now how this works, Grasshopper for each point will check which the closest part in this attractor curve, the closest part to it, and will create a point there. Now, I will make it more interesting by, you know, have this line contain more than just two endpoints, so I can play with its shape. So I will click on it and use rebuild tool. I will, okay, 4 points, it's enough for now. So delete input. So now if I click it and press F10, I can choose the points. You can see the placement of the point changes. So, and here we have the distances. Same like before, we will use this the distances values to move these points here. So what I will do, I will bring everything from here except this part, of course, up. I will bring all of these. Control C, Control V. For the distances here in the remap, also bound. The points I want to move, are these points here. If I show the result, you can see And for the loft, I will use the original line. Press shift. Here we have the spline. I will press shift to add . Here we can see the loft. Here we can see the extrusion. I can hide those. I can hide everything. And now I can manipulate the line. I can rebuild this line and add more points. Let's say 6. F10. Here, what we did, and you can see this in the second video, the remap. Basically, we took the original distances and we used this remap thing so that we can control the minimum and maximum extrusion at the minimum and maximum move. So basically here I'm not using the original distances directly. What I'm doing is that here in the remap, you give it the original distances, and then we use the bound component. This will give us the minimum and the maximum in this list of distances. And then we use a construct domain, and we choose a minimum distance and maximum. So what will happen is that Grasshopper will take the original distances and will use the bound so that it will know where it needs to grab the original distances and remap them into this new range, so that the minimum distance will have this value and the maximum will have this value. So now I can be sure that the maximum distance will not exceed this number. It will be exactly this number, and the minimum it will be this. And the values in between will be redistributed, and they will preserve the relative relation between them. So hopefully you like this video, and you can play around, practice, and experiment. And yeah, like I said, I recommend that you watch the first two videos so you can have an idea about this logic, about the attractor thing. And if you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next video. Thank you.